Welcome. So in this session, we will write our test. So the first BDD test, we will see how to write.
I'm Kumar and welcome to my channel on tech and tutorials.
So let us start by adding a new folder in our existing project. We'll create a directory and we will name it as BDD Pytest. So let's start to organize our test. So for that, let us put all the feature files in a separate directory, and then we will have our test modules in this same folder, Pytest-BDD. So let's create another directory where we will put all the features. We don't need to name it as features. This is the folder name, so just name it as my features. So usually if we are trying to build an automation framework, then in that case you would want to name this as something correlated with your features, but for this demo we'll just name it as my features, and then we will start to put our test modules inside this BDD Pytest folder. So let us start by writing our feature file first and start by creating the file name. So first 101 dot. So Pycharm has a plugin for this feature. First let me start by adding the feature file, then we will also need to install the package Pytest-BDD. So let us create this feature file first, 101.feature, and so the first line should be the feature. Let's see a simple example of bank transaction, and let me just write it down fast so that we can concentrate on the actual test. So bank transactions, and okay, so the first feature, some we have to put some name here, feature, and then we are planning to write some test on the transactions like addition and subtraction, which translates to withdrawal and deposit. So the next line is an optional description which describes what actually this feature is all about. Next, we start to add our scenarios. So scenario, and we can put some name, withdrawal of money, and then we can write the given, the account balance is say $100, and then we'll put the when. This is the given condition where we set up the required condition for our test, and then in the next step, when step, we will do the actual test of the scenario. So the test is the account holder withdraws say $30, then what is the expected condition? The account balance should be $70. So for now I have just typed in all this information. We can actually parameterize all this, but we'll see that in the subsequent sections of our Pytest-BDD framework. So this is our whole scenario, and with all these steps and with all the conditions. So we are supposed to write the code for executing this scenario or test scenario or user scenario, whatever you want to say. Okay, let me show you one thing. Settings and plugin. Gherkin plugin is already installed for my Pycharm. That's how it is able to identify this as a feature file, and you see all these icons for the feature file. This is what I installed after I started to work on Pytest-BDD in this project. Need to install this plugin in Pycharm. The other thing is we need to install Pytest-BDD. So let us start to write our first test, and then we can install our Pytest-BDD package. So it's a Python file. We have to follow the Pytest way of writing. So test_d test_bdd101, and okay, so we have to import from Pytest_BDD, but Pytest_BDD is not available in this virtual environment yet. So let us go ahead and install this one. Terminal and pip install Pytest-BDD. Okay, so looks like the installation is done. Let's come back here. Okay, now doesn't show the red underscore. Okay, so we have to import all these functions, methods inside this Pytest-BDD. We have to import all these decorators from the Pytest-BDD module. So let us go ahead and add some code. Okay, we need to import the feature file. So for that, we are using this pathlib module to import the feature file. Next. Okay, so this code you might be knowing. So we have already used this code in the earlier sessions where we were importing about the config files and all. So you can refer that if you are not sure. And we will use the same code here because we are trying to import from the my features folder our feature file. First 101.feature file, we need to import it in our test module file. So we need to add these lines of code. Next, we'll add a variable. Basically, it's a global variable we need to add, and we will use this global variable in our test just to demonstrate the withdrawal and the deposit of money in the account. So I need to import Pytest. Okay, this is fine now. So let us start to write our test. So first thing we need to do is we need to add the decorator scenario, and we need to provide the feature file, which this variable here we are reversing to the feature file first 101 with these lines of code, and then we need to add the name of the scenario that we are trying to test, so withdrawal of money. And then we need to define a function. This function actually doesn't do anything, but we need to add this, and we can just add a pass. This function runs after the execution of all the given when and then, and this function also serves as an indicator when we will run this test. We will see this is the name of the test which we will see in our report, test report. Just to demonstrate, what I will do is I can add a print statement here so that we'll know that this function gets executed in the end of our test, and withdrawal test. Okay, so now let's go ahead writing the main test file. So for that we have to add the given decorator, and we need to provide the given steps definition in this decorator. So the account balance is 100 to put it inside of the quotes. Okay, and then we have to define the function. So the account balance is 100. So here we need to use our code to get to this state of account balance. So what I will do is I can just put current balance. And okay, so yeah, we defined this variable, global variable, to work on this one. So we'll use this global variable and we will assign a value of 100 here. We are setting up our application for test. So this is the given condition. In case if we are trying to test some Selenium UI test or something like that, then in this stage or in this state, what we will be doing is we will be opening the browser and going to the page on which we want to test. Okay, so the next one is we need the then condition. So we can define the then condition and can go to this feature file, and we can copy this account holder withdraws 30, and we can withdraw amount, and then we can use our same variable pytest.amount, and we can do is minus 30. So we are withdrawing a value of 30 from our initial value of 100. That's what we are doing. And the final condition is given. Okay, sorry. So this should be when, given, when, and then. And the final condition is then. And in this case, we are checking that our test is successful. This is the place where you assert that our test is successful. So this is the way of writing a BDD test, behavioral driven development test. And what we'll do is we will assert that pytest.mt has a value of what, 70. Okay, and I forgot to define the function final balance. Okay, so this completes our whole test. Go through this whole test and try to understand it. Here what we are doing is first we are setting up everything for our test. The current balance in this case we are setting it up to 100, and in the when condition we are doing the actual testing. So this code is the main test code here, where it is actually doing the test, where we are executing the user scenario. That means in this case we are supposed to withdraw an amount of 30 from the initial balance of 100. And if we are talking in terms of some UI test, we are supposed to click some buttons, we are supposed to write some text into some text box and all. Those type of code will come into the when condition, when step. And then in the final step, where we define the asserts, where we'll check that our test is successful or not, in that function we will write our test assertion code. So this completes the whole test. For one single test, you need to write all these functions and all these decorators you need to use. So this is an easy way for the business persons or executives other than the engineers to understand the whole flow of test. So as I was saying earlier, a business executive or anybody, if you want to share your test, you can share your feature file and they can read through this easily and they can understand what this test is actually supposed to do and what this test is intended for. So let's look into executing our first BDD test. So now that we have completed our test, our first BDD test, let us go ahead and run this test and see the report. Okay, you can right click and just run it from here. Okay, so looks like it failed and assertion failed. So our test failed. This is a real good start. Failures are pillars. Unless we fall, we don't learn to get up. Now let's see how to fix this. Okay, so file not found. So something is wrong here. Let's try to figure that out. So scenarios. So we are supposed to write scenario here, not scenarios. I will show you when you are supposed to write scenarios. In one case where we are referring the whole feature file, we are supposed to write scenarios. But in this case, we are targeting a specific test. test scenario here, the first scenarios. That's why we have to provide scenario. So that's a mistake which we need to be careful about when we write our test. Otherwise, we'll keep on debugging and then we will not be able to figure out. So let us try to run our test and see that was the actual problem. Okay, so yep, this is fine now. Now you see here, end of withdrawal test. As I was saying earlier, this test, test underscore withdrawal, this function will run in the end of our test. So that's why you are seeing this line, end of withdrawal test. Okay, anyway, coming back to our test, and you see that test underscore withdrawal here. This is the name of the test. This is the name of the test function, test underscore withdrawal, which you see. So, and it's showing a status of passed, 100% passed. Okay, so that's good now. And that completes our first test on BDD. And we have learned how to write a BDD test. So thank you for watching. I hope it has helped you in some way. Please don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe in order to support me. Thanks for that. See you in the next video.